I'm really happy to be here because I was such a big fan of Sri Chinmoy's and everyone here. And they've been working on this project for years, which they do. And just to see it here, and we're in Tribeca, I mean, what are you kidding me? It's a big, big pleasure for me to be here tonight.
What do you find so inspiring about the story?
Well, first of all, Sri Chinmoy, I'd known him a long time, you know, more than 25 years. And he never had a bad day, and he never had a bad thing to say about anyone. He always was tuned into your life, and he always inspired you, and he always gave you energy. And he went to every single one of my Olympic Games and all the, I mean, because that's what Sri Chinmoy did. And he never asked anything of you other than just to be the best you can be and treat people how you want to be treated and then find the supreme. That's really it. So someone who gave everything and only asked a little bit, I mean, how can you beat that?
Can you name a couple points in your life where, you know, you looked at his attitude on things and you said this is probably the way to go?
I'll tell you one thing specific. I was ill back in, it was 2003, and I was physically down. I had an operation, actually. And right after that, I'd lost like 25 pounds. I came to see Sri Chinmoy, and he kind of saw me. He said, God, he's really thin, you know. So he called me back privately, and he says, what are you doing for people? You know. And I said, well, I've been talking to these people, yada, yada, yada. And he says, you know what? Go back to your high school and talk to the kids at your high school. And don't come back to me until you've done it. So that was 2004, 2003. I ended up working it out. And not only my high school, I spoke to every school in my district in early 2004. And it changed my life. And 2005, I moved back to New Jersey. And now I'm there. And I've been coaching with the team. I've been doing that. But he saw where I needed to be. And I'm not thrilled with the weather here. But the thing is that I wake up every day saying, how in the heck did I get here? Because this is exactly where I'm supposed to be.
Can you give us a little bit about your feelings of what might happen in 2012 with the Olympics? Is that a good place for track and field? What do you think about what's coming in the next year?
Oh, I think the Olympics are going to be great. I was just there last month. I was visited the Olympic Stadium. I was with Nadia Comaneci and Seb Coe. The three of us were in the stadium. I saw the stadium. I think it's going to be great. London's a great place to be. It's easy for most people. Television's going to be great. I think it's going to be a tremendous games, and I look forward to it.
Wonderful. Well, thanks so much for speaking with me. This has been a dream.
Great. Thank you.
Congratulations on your film, Challenging Impossibility, being part of Tribeca Fest.
Thank you very much. I mean, it's been a great ride for us. This is just my second film, and Tribeca has accepted it and, you know, has really nurtured us along the filmmaking process.
Has it surprised you that the kind of people who've come out to support this film?
You know, we were afraid of not being able to sell any tickets for our film, but we've sold out the first and last screening, and it's a good problem to have.
And you've got some amazing people involved with the film, too. I mean, Carl Lewis among them. Can you maybe tell us how that came about?
Yeah, the film is about Sri Chinmoy, the late spiritual teacher, who in his 50s took up weightlifting in order to show that inner peace could be a source of outer power. And he developed a lot of friends in the athletics world, from Carl Lewis to Frank Zane to World's Strongest Man, Hugo Girard. They were all part of the movie, and they were, you know, thrilled to come to New York from all corners of North America to be part of the premiere. So we were very lucky. We have a great cast.
Well, it's a pleasure to talk to you, and congrats again on your film being part of the 10th anniversary here.
Thank you very much. It's a real honor for us to be here.
Can you tell us a bit about how you got involved with this film?
Well, I've known Sri Chinmoy since 1988 and have done different things. I've attended his marathon lifting sessions and been uplifted at least a half a dozen times. And also, I'm a musician. He's invited me to play at his concerts. I've written several songs about him and play chromatic harmonica, which I'll be doing tomorrow night at their gathering. So through a mutual interest in weight training and music, we've grown together over the years.
What is it specifically? Because there's some amazing people from the weightlifting world, the bodybuilding world, who got involved with this film. How is there a step-by-step kind of connection between the spiritual philosophy and what you're doing physically?
I think there is. I mean, I've always been interested in the spirituality part of it ever since I started. I basically took up weight training at age 14 and started practicing yoga at the same time and meditation. And I've pretty much carried out the meditation ever since, so it's only natural that we would meet and hook up and share common interests. And Sri Chinmoy has been great. I mean, I've never met kinder people in my life. And it's been very motivational for me, seeing an example like that, and his example that he set. And it's been very inspiring. You know, there's times in your training you don't feel like doing it, and you just think about what he's doing, and then you're in the gym again.
Well, thanks so much for speaking with us.
Yeah.